In the day's other news, rioting broke out at a prison in southern Iran, adding to a series of violent outbursts at prisons in the country. Officials say no one escaped in the latest incident. Iran has already furloughed some 100,000 inmates to curb the spread of COVID-19. Also today, Afghanistan began releasing some 10,000 prisoners. Inmates lined up to have their temperature checked by men in protective suits, and then they were reunited with their relatives outside. Taliban members were not released. Afghan officials blamed the militants for attacks today that killed 27 soldiers and police. Police in the Netherlands are searching for a Vincent van Gogh painting, the Parsonage Garden at Nuenen in spring 1884. Investigators say thieves stole the artwork from the Singer Laren Museum east of Amsterdam early today after smashing a glass door and breaking in.
Who does such a thing? That is a parallel world of crime and money that we do not belong to. We are of the world of culture. We are here to share art and culture, which is much needed for society, with the people.
There's no word on the painting's value, but Van Gogh's can fetch millions at auction. Back in this country, a federal judge today blocked Texas from banning most abortions during the coronavirus crisis. The state's Republican attorney general had included abortions in an order to postpone procedures deemed not medically necessary. The judge ruled the state is violating a fundamental right. And the coronavirus has claimed two lives in the music world. Alan Merrill died on Sunday in New York. He co-wrote I Love Rock and Roll, a hit for Joan Jett in 1982. He was 69 years old. And country star Joe Diffie has died in Nashville. His hits in the 1990s included Home and Pickup Man. Joe Diffie was 61 years old. Still to come on the NewsHour, the pandemic and the gig economy. The virus's toll on Americans who don't work 9 to 5. Plus, Amy Walter and Tamara Keith on how COVID-19 is upending the political landscape.
This is the PBS NewsHour from WETA Studios in Washington and in the West from the Walter Cronkite School of Journalism at Arizona State University.